July the 18th, 1976, the Kiev was revealed to the world. Although it was carrying over 20 Yak-38 aircraft, the Soviets did not refer to it as an aircraft carrier. It was called a submarine intercepting cruiser. This was to avoid provisions of the 1936 Montreux Convention, which forbade the passage of any aircraft carrier through the Bosphorus. The Turkish government didn't argue, and the first Soviet carrier cruised unchallenged into the Mediterranean. Kiev, which was 900 feet long and weighed 39,000 tons, was not a large carrier by Western standards, but it symbolized the end of a 50-year struggle to get a Soviet carrier afloat. Stalin had criticized the carrier as too expensive and vulnerable, and Khrushchev had called it a weapon of the past. But for those who had survived the long argument for the Soviet Union's carrier, the event of this summer day in 1976 was some vindication. The Kiev was well armed. It had extensive missile control radar for its surface-to-surface and surface-to-air missiles, and a battery of rocket launchers and cannon. But of most interest to Western military analysts was the presence of the new Soviet VTOL aircraft, which NATO quickly named Forger A. The squadron of Forgers has the job of intercepting enemy patrol and anti-submarine aircraft prying into airspace outside the range of the Kiev's defensive missiles. The Forger also gives mid-course guidance to Soviet anti-ship missiles. The standard takeoff weight of 10 tons includes 2,200 pounds of weapons and 5,000 pounds of internal fuel. However, this load can be increased if a short takeoff is used. The Forger can reach supersonic speeds, but only just. It was clocked by an American interceptor at Mach 1.05. Its rate of climb is about 15,000 feet a minute, and its ceiling is 40,000 feet. Its wing area is 4 square meters less than its Western counterpart, the Harrier. The Kiev is not a large carrier, and the aircraft's wings need to be folded for storage. There's an elevator in the stern of the ship that can bring one aircraft at a time to or from the hangar.